Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to my channel, Electrical Installation Triple E. Just remember to smash a like on the video and also share. And you can also leave a comment and ask Christian, because whenever time off time, you know, I always try to reach out back to the fans. It's been a while, but yeah, I have a lot of videos that I haven't edited as yet. A whole lot of videos. Taking pipe, you know, etc. All these things. And some SWA cable installation, all those things. Yeah, but I haven't edited them as yet. They took take a while to actually get some real camera settings in. But now I'm trying to do much better, trying to get something more close up where I can actually get a better view on what I'm doing. Still have to use the phone as well because of circumstance and so forth. But yeah, make sure you smash a like on the video. Share, tell a friend as usual, and yeah, my channel more likely is all about education and try to teach as much as I can, and beneficial for the youths them as well who live in high school, going to heart and so forth. Even big man, it doesn't matter the age gap, once you are young electrician, because you have electrician going to school right now in their 50s, 40s, can't too old for learn. So our channel is all about for the young electricians, upcoming electricians, and even the one them who maybe think they know it all as well. We all learn off each other. But today's video is all about some testers that I got. I have a whole lot of testers. And I'm going to demonstrate some of them, not all. But I'm going to do videos individually with using some of these testers as well. So these are my testers that I use a lot. It's a lot. It's a whole lot for me, to be honest. But yeah, I have workers with me, so they also can use it. There are certain ones that they cannot touch because certain ones are just special for me. Even though it's gonna be strange, to be honest, because this one right here, this is my baby, to be honest. This is, I think, the second tester I own from 2006, and it actually was given to me. Not even was a friend, to be honest. It was someone saw me working and have it and said, yo, you need something like this. The other one that I got, I think it was $800 that I paid for it. Easy to get damaged, so, but it helped me. But this, from ever since, one of the main reasons why I like this is the fact that when you're doing continuous tests, like your ohms out circuit, like whenever time you wire house and you want to check for any charges or anything like that, this one, you just don't miss, honestly. Like, it just don't miss. You can look at it and see. There's another wire that we normally have. This was a red wire, but can't find it. Rarely use it, so. But yeah, this just definitely doesn't miss. It's my baby. Even voltage, whenever time, I remember one time I have this one right here, and I was testing for voltage, and this one wasn't accurate enough. It was giving me like something like 86, you know, this one is a digital one, it was giving me something like 86, and this one actually give me the full, I think it gave me 110 volt, and the current was okay because I used something else and do a test on it as well, and I got 110 as well. So I guess this one more accurate, I don't know. Leave a comment if you think this one is more accurate or what, but I used this one before. Maybe it was malfunction at the time, I don't know. But yeah, this one is my baby. Love it to death. I don't know if anyone gonna get this tester anymore. I don't know if they sell anymore. But yeah. This one is a volt stick. This one right here is a volt stick. Just use it to test voltage. And every time you use it, you can put your finger right here. And you just use the tip right here. And you can get current. You also have a flashlight right here. But
That is when you have the power on it or the battery, the flashlight right there. It's up to 690 volt. You can do both AC and DC as well, and it also can do connected to test as well. I'm going to do use this and do a test on it, see how you guys demonstrate how it works. Alright, right here is where you put in bocce. These bocces, you can test it without the bocce. So what I'm going to do right now, this right here is an extension. You can see the power is on right here. So I'm going to stick this right here because this is not long enough to go inside here. So I'm going to stick this right here. And also I'm going to put the neutral on right here. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to test to see. So I'm getting 100, you can see the reading right there, 113. Okay, so I get 113 volt. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the battery inside of it. So now I have the battery inside of it, I'm going to do another test on it. So I'm going to stick back this wire right in there. So I'm getting 113 volt as well. So this volt stick, it can operate with bocce and without bocce. It can operate with bocce and without bocce. Okay. Well, every electrician, I don't know, most electricians have this, you know, regular tester. Just stick it in there and you see the light come right there, and that's pretty much it. So that tell you that that one is, there is juice there. Or you... Yeah, this one is my infrared thermometer. Purpose of this is actually to, if you have any breaker that is overheating, like it's getting warm or so forth like that, wires that is getting warm, you can use it and put it on it and you can tell. So yeah, so sometimes some circuits just overload, the breaker feel warm, you can use this. So whenever time you go near the breaker panel, if you don't want to touch the breaker panel, you can use this on it. And also wires as well, you can use it. Yeah, so this one right here is my digital circuit breaker finder. So what you can do, you can use this to find for instance a particular circuit in the house, in case you don't want to switch off every breaker, you just want to find that specific breaker to lock down that power. And what you can do, it come with this as well. It come with this. Yeah, it come with this, and this serve a lot of purpose as well. You can see open ground, that means the ground wire is not connected. You can see open neutral, meaning the neutral is not connected. Open hot, meaning that there is no connection with the hot wire. Hot and ground reverse, that means that they're both not connected. So whenever time you see the two red on this right here, meaning that the wires are connected properly. So what you can do, you can use this and you can plug it in a socket in the house, and then it will light up. Then you go to the breaker panel as well, and then you can just press this on right here, and then you scroll go down, and then you will find the breaker, switch off the breaker, and then the light on this will come off. So yeah, I will do a video on that as well. Same thing with this. This is like a GFCI tester, and you can check for the neutral wire. The same thing. Whenever if the neutral wire is not connected properly or not connected or it open, this can tell grounds as well. So I have a few of them. Well, most electricians have these. Very simple, ABC. Just press and turn on the power button right here, and then you just put it in. Yeah, you just push it in right there, and then you will know. This is a volt tester, so see the wires right there. So if you want to test a voltage, you can test up to 240 voltage. Yeah. It's very pretty useful, very handy as well. This one I rarely use. This one, this is like a laser distance measuring. So what you do, you turn on it. So you have it right there. So it's between distance. So wherever you're at, as you can see right there. So wherever you're at, between that and right here, you can get your distance measurement. This is what I should take off, but yeah, never used it before. I have no reason to, but right here you can see where you have a lever, so you can lever it right here. Yeah, and then you can check your distance from the starting point right here. And it also have a right here where you can screw in like a selfie stick, so you don't have to move. It's pretty useful, but not for my purpose. This one right here, you call it a smart meter, so it can test pretty much everything as well. All you have to do is just right here, you turn it on, the power button right here. And then you can you press this right here. Right now it's on ohms, and then you can click it to something else. Right. So you just have to use this to select whatever you're testing for. And also come with these are the wires that they use to, and so forth. This is the one I currently use. Like, I use this regular, I use this on a regular basis. This is the main one that I really use. It's called the clamp on. Yeah. I use this one a lot. Here I have another one. Nobody no asking nothing because I'm not giving any away. I'm keeping all of them. So this is what you plug into the socket. So we have a socket right here. And then you can test for your amperage, anything. So what you can do with this now, you can plug your load right in here. After you plug this in the socket, you plug your load right in here. And then you can test for the amperage or anything like that that you want to test for with this. See it also come with this as well. So any fault along the way, you can use it as well. Last but not least, I have a lot of Klein tools, to be honest. Brand new. Never used. You see, yes, so this is what you use to plug in right here to do your test. And this is for the thermo copper. So this, you can see right here, this have a positive and a negative on it. Let me look at it. This come with a positive and a negative. Yes, you can see it right here, positive and negative. So you plug it in like this, like that. Yeah, don't use this, to be honest. So, but yeah. These are the testers that almost every electrician have. Most electricians just use this just a test to get current, or they use something like this. I used to use them. This magnetizer is very useful. A lot of time there are screws in some areas and you want to catch it, and it's very hard to catch it, because the screwdriver doesn't have a magnet on it. So that's it for me, guys, with another video. I'm gonna do some individual videos on these testers, demonstrating how to use them, because a lot of people don't know how to use testers on a wall and certain testers. So I'm gonna do individual videos on them and show you guys how to use them, and also a lot of the symbols on it. A lot of people don't know the meaning of them. So I will do a video on that as well. Until next time, guys, stay safe.